One of the fundamental features of life on Earth is circadian rhythms. These 24-hour oscillations of our endogenous biology are seen across all living things on Earth. This includes humans, bacteria, insects, and plants. I study circadian rhythms because I think they're fundamentally important for human health, and I think the concept of time of day variation is something that has not been appreciated in the medical field. So research in my lab is focused on trying to understand the role of the molecular clock in skeletal muscle. In addition, we're also trying to understand ways in which we might be able to target the molecular clock in muscle as a therapeutic strategy for issues associated with aging and many chronic diseases. We're excited as we move forward because we have different genetic and environmental approaches that provide us with the tools for discovery to identify the molecules that are communicating between the muscle and the system. So one of the surprising things we found in our study is that when we disrupt the muscle clock, we see changes in sleep and blood pressure and core body temperature, as well as gene expression changes throughout many organ systems in the body. From the hospital perspective, how do we set up the lighting? What kind of wavelength of lighting do we have in the hospitals? Do we adjust them for what we think of as dawn and dusk? So this would affect the patients, particularly in ICUs. So I'm fortunate to be at the University of Florida as a member of the Myology Institute. This new institute is the largest cluster of researchers in skeletal muscle health and disease in the United States. But in addition to the Myology Institute, University of Florida also provides a very open and collaborative research environment. And this is critical for my studies that look beyond muscle to other organ systems in the body. I'm Karyn Esser, and I am part of the research landscape at the University of Florida.